10 Most Elite Special Forces. Number 10. The Danish Huntsman. Throughout the Cold War, the Danish Huntsman trained to unbelievable levels that would be gruesome to any well-trained soldier on the planet. In order to be part of the crew, these special forces are pushed to the absolute limit, mentally and physically. These elite soldiers are part of the Royal Danish Army, and their primary tasks include unconventional warfare, covert ops, combat search and rescue, direct action, and counter-terrorism. Other missions they might be asked to partake in include hostage rescue, sabotage, and information operations. Also known as the Jaegers, which means hunters in Danish, included reconnaissance missions in Afghanistan and direct action raids on the Taliban and Al-Qaeda. Snipers are equipped with a PSG-1 Heckler & Koch 7.26 caliber rifle with the effective range of more than 800 yards. Number 9. Taiwan Special Forces. Taiwan has openly wanted their own independence. Therefore, having their own elite special forces is necessary. A Japanese news company got a hold of these photos, and many are wondering what the Taiwanese might have up their sleeve if China decides to attack them. These masks were put on during a military display, which the Taiwanese claim to be bulletproof from close range. They say it can stop a .357 caliber slug pointed at them from point-blank range. Number 8. The GIGN. GIGN is the elite law enforcement and special operations of France and stands for Groupe d'Intervention de la Gendarmerie Nationale. Due to many terrorist attacks targeted on the freedom of the French joie de vivre, GIGN cannot afford to fail and must be perfect. In a country where guns are not freely allowed like in the US, these people receive the most intense firearm qualifications. Since the creation of the group, they've taken part in over 1,800 operations, liberating 600 hostages, and arresting 1,500 people. They managed to neutralize two armed suspects during the Charlie Hebdo shooting in January 2015. In June 2016, the two robbers decided to rob the wrong McDonald's, where there were two off-duty GIGN agents who were enjoying a meal in the city of Besançon. They pounced on the shotgun-wielding robbers, leaving one of them with a hole through the abdomen and the other in handcuffs. Number 7. The Green Berets. Different branches of the military in the US have their own special forces. For the US Army, they've got the Green Berets, getting the nickname from their special headgear. They were first activated in 1952 during the Korean War and were noted for their extensive airborne units. The Green Berets continued to kick butt, especially during the Vietnam War, where they engaged in organized guerrilla attacks on North Vietnam. Green Berets have been deployed on missions around the globe, including operations in Bosnia, Haiti, Kosovo, the Philippines, Afghanistan, and in both wars in Iraq. Number 6. Sayeret Matkal. This special forces unit comes from the Israeli Defense Forces and are a key factor in keeping Israel safe. Since this country is surrounded by enemies, having an elite special forces is necessary to deal with the amount of terrorism that goes on here. While every healthy Israeli national is supposed to serve their country at some point in their life, these soldiers are carefully selected to be the smartest and to be in the best physical condition available. With the rise of Palestinian resistance in the late 1960s, this group of elite soldiers were sent out behind enemy lines to conduct hostage rescue missions. In 2008, they executed an assassination of a top Syrian general named Mohammed Sleiman, who was enjoying a seaside dinner party in the city of Tartus. This mission was completed by pulling a silent boat up to the coastline and shooting him with a silent sniper rifle. This intense mission possibly saved Israel from becoming the victim of an all-out invasion. Number 5. India's Paratroopers. India's paratroopers are the country's special strike force, and these elitely trained soldiers are dropped off behind enemy lines out of airplanes to conduct various operations. With so much tension between India and Pakistan, having these soldiers in their arsenal will help eliminate threats that are posed on their country daily. They often sport a maroon beret, but in order to get this, they certainly have to make the cut. Only 10% of recruits will earn their berets, making this one of the most exclusive special forces in the world. The Discovery Channel was eventually permitted to get a close look at one of the most intense military selection courses in the world. This regiment has seen heavy action in regions like Kashmir, which has been a disputed territory for decades. They also have quite the advanced arsenal, with the IMI Galil sniper rifle as their preferred weapon. Number 4. KSK Germany. KSK stands for Kommando Spezialkraft, which translates roughly to Special Forces Command. These soldiers are handpicked from the ranks of Germany's Unified Defense Forces. They've received much praise from NATO and the US for their efficiency, making them often requested to carry out anti-terror operations. Since Germany isn't allowed to have a traditional standing or offensive army after World War II, they focus their attention on threats on their home soil. This gives them the time and the money to focus on elite groups such as the KSK. The AG-36 that you see here is attached with a grenade launcher and can do some serious damage. This is also their standard full-auto rifle used to carry out operations. They've occasionally been touted as the world's best special forces, and only 8 to 10% of candidates successfully pass training. Number 3, Navy SEALs. When you think of special forces, normally the Navy SEALs will come to mind. The Navy SEALs have displayed excellence since they were formed in 1962. Their operations are considered to be some of the most crucial and risky. They were credited for the assassination of Osama bin Laden in 2011 at his hideout in Pakistan during Operation Neptune Spirit. Most people drop out during the grueling physical training. The average Navy SEAL must be in tip-top physical condition and can bust out 79 push-ups in 2 minutes. They also have to be able to run 1.5 miles in 10 minutes. They certainly don't negotiate with terrorists. During Operation Jubilee in Afghanistan, the Taliban offered a prisoner exchange. The Navy SEALs and British Special Forces were sent to rescue the hostages that were hidden in the caves. They then killed the gunmen and rescued a total of 4 hostages. Neither the SEALs nor the hostages were injured. Number 2, SAS. The British Special Air Service is without a doubt one of the most secretive and elite military organizations in the world. It carefully guards its operations and secrets, so it's hard to do research on them. While much of this organization is shrouded in mystery, the public did finally see them be put to use during a hostage situation in May 1980, where 26 people were kept captive in an Iranian embassy in South Kensington. After a gunman took the life of a hostage, the SAS was called in to do work. 25 of the 26 hostages were rescued, and 5 of the 6 hostage takers were killed, and the other was captured. People were quite impressed with their ability to swiftly take care of the situation. The modern-day SAS are quite advanced too. Here we see the modern-day SAS equipped with cameras on their heads, dressed in a desert camouflage, and ready for their next mission. And number 1, Spetsnaz Special Forces. Also known as the Alpha Group, these special forces were created by the KGB and the Soviet Union during the 1970s. They became possibly the most brutal and toughest special forces on the planet. No mission is impossible for these guys, and they live up to the reputation of being one of the most renowned special forces to ever exist. According to a book by Viktor Suvorov, the training is certainly no cakewalk. Soldiers must withstand pain management training, which includes a punch to the chest by a commanding officer, and getting a burning cinder block smashed on their abdomen with a sledgehammer. Spetsnaz certainly have a unique set of standards and prepare for soldiers for the violence and gruesomeness of war. In Victor's book, he explains a scenario where the soldiers were waking up in the middle of the night and sent to an abandoned house. While they first thought they were walking through water, a light turns on and they find out that they're in fact knee-deep in pig's blood and other remains of this animal. This is to psychologically prepare them for the atrocities they might have to witness. And there's much to be said about this special group. They're also credited for some difficult missions like the Moscow theater hostage situation. They also went inside the presidential palace inside Kabul, Afghanistan, killed everybody inside, and captured their president.